Hello everyone, today I will talk about my game against dice from the Star Sharks. This game was in black and white OU and was the third one I had to play in the past SPL. The score at the moment of the game was 5-3 in favor of my team, the Circus Maximus Tigers. With that being said, let's move to the team building. Alright, so let's talk about the teams that I brought against dice. I remember at the time I was liking the idea of gems in black and white in general, because Sun and Moon was new and the novelty chair to try out and watch, and I liked how the Z move worked and what they brought to the game as a one-time special attack that is more powerful. And I thought that gem could work in a similar way, although obviously they're not as good, but I liked the idea in general. So I was kind of thinking about it and looking for inspiration. I also watched previous SPL games, and I saw one game from Just Peachy that had DD Latios with Grand Gem, and I really liked the idea. So I made a team around it, and that's what I ended up using against Ice. So let's talk about the Pokemon individually. Latios first. So what did I like about Latios? First of all, it's pretty cool. Like, it has that nice originality factor. DD Latios is not something you see often, and I like the idea in general. Really good speed tier, 110. At plus 1, you outspeed pretty much all the Scarfers in the tier, and the common one being Garchomp, Keldeo, Cheraxian, Jirachi. You outspeed them, you kill them too, and at worst, you tie with the other Latios, but they are not common anyway. Grand Gem, really good idea on this Latios from Peachy. At plus 1, Earthquake with the Grand Gem boost will one-shot max HP Tyranitar and max HP Jirachi afterwards, which are the two most common answers to Latios in the tier. So that's something I really liked. Outrage for the main stat that is really pretty strong in general. And then in the last slot, there are a lot of options, I'd say. And I went with Zenithbird because it made sense with the two partners I had here, Magnezone and Tyranitar. I'll explain why a bit later. But there are a lot of options you could consider yourself, like a Surfer or T-Bolt or whatever. Also regarding the item, Life Orb and Lumberry are pretty good in general, but I like the gem. So next up, Magnezone, kind of obvious, I guess, as a dragon partner, you know what it does, it will trap the steel and open the way for your dragon. In this team, I used it principally for Skarmory and Scizor, and that's why I have a Shuffleberry. Didn't need the specs boost for those two. HP 5 for Scizor, Thunderbolt for Skarmory, which what is also pretty good about Magnezone in general in black and white, and that I really like, is that it just can remove Skarmory out of the picture, which is a really hard Pokemon to beat and can be a pain in the ass on the long term. And it also gives me an option to kind of control the Hazards game. Like, if I can kill Skarmory as it gets only one spice, that's good. So it doesn't put too much pressure on my team. Shuffleberry here, I liked fighting resist in general. In Magnezone, it allows him to kind of beat Terrakion and Alakazam. Like, you take the Focus Blast or Ghost Combat, you can tear with them, and then they are out of commission for the rest of the game. And it can comes in handy against other things like Keldeo. Next up, Tyranitar. I added Tyranitar because it has the nice combo of Shuckaberry and Ice Beam, and it allows it to remove Landorusty from the picture. And Landorusty being a great check for this DD Latios, Tyranitar made perfect sense here. Also, it can bring Rocks and a Razor to the table. I don't really need to win the Reservoir against Rain, although it's appreciated. And just in case I would face Sun, I had my own Razor on the board, because facing Sun without a Razor on your own can be an utter loss. So Tyranitar here, the EVs, max, this special attack, if I remember correctly, gets the one shot on Garchomp and max HP on Rusty. I'm sure about Garchomp, and I'm pretty sure Landorusty after Rocks, you kill them. I decided to go with a full special moveset, so I wouldn't put the EVs everywhere, and I can keep some speed and a nice book to tank on various threats. Oh, I'll just mention that I didn't run Pursuit, And while it can be kind of a problem because you don't get to trap like the lattice, most of the time they will stay here anyway because they expect the pursuit. So you can just abuse that fact and still kill them. Next up, Rotom. I remember I just didn't put much thought into Rotom in general. It was on the Peaches team and I liked it because it's a nice PvP early game. It can take some stuff, spread damages, give you momentum, and yeah, that's the didn't think too much about it. Max special defense to better tank water sweepers. Also, something else that is pretty good here with Rotom is that it's a ground immunity that isn't weak to U-turn, so I don't have to send like Londrosity doesn't have free Earthquake on this team, otherwise I would have to send Latios and it can't take U-turn and that's not good. Next up, Scarf Garchomp, which is in my opinion the best Scarfer in Black and White, and in most people's opinions anyway, as it's super common right now. I just added him because I like to have a Scarfer in general, so some stuff don't go out of control, like Volcarona. Also in this team, it works even better, like it synergizes really well with Latios because it takes advantage of the things that Magneson Trap and Charizard lose. And Latios and like DT Latios and Scarf Garchomp have kind of the same check as they hit in the same types with Earthquake and Outrage. So you can weaken stuff with Latios and clean the game with Garchomp afterward. So yeah, works like because I want the accuracy and this move is only for Volcarona anyway, like most of the time. So I'd rather be accurate. Dual Chop, it can one-shot Alakazam through his Focus Sash, and since I don't have Chopper Tarita, it's something I also wanted on my Scarfer. In the last slot, Jirachi, just like one of the best Pokémon Black and White. Made sense here, it's a second Steel type, and Magzone isn't that bulky anyway, so and doesn't have passive recovery, so it can act as a Dragon Check. Also, I wanted to run Jirachi because in the second week when I played Shoka, Jirachi, the Smogon user, had to face Dice. And we prepared the beat together for his game, for our game, but his game too. And he told me that he thought Mixed Jirachi would work really well against most of Dice builds. So I went with it, decided to hide him too. Also, I could afford Sub and not run a Fire Move for maximum coverage because I have Magnezone for Scizor anyway and Ferrothorn if it comes down to it. Sub, another good reason to run it in this team is that Mew is a big weakness, like Stalbreaker Mew with Willow Wisp and Ice Beam. And since I'm faster, I can sub in front of it and then actually start to rack up damages. Also, Sub really good in Black and White general. I made a post about it recently on Smogon to just avoid status, especially because people like to run Among Us and you can have a free sub on Among Us and then you start doing Jirachi things, you know. I see win pretty cool here to have a formal speed control as well. So yeah, with that being said, let's move to the game. Alright, so here we are, game time. Just as a little note, I played all my SPL games on Sunday. Something I already do a lot, or did a lot in the past, but in this SPL I exclusively played on Sunday. Anyway, looking at team preview, let's see what could stop Latios. There is obviously Skarmory, but everything else is potentially cleaned by Latios at plus one. I just need some damages on Rotom. I can actually lose the Latios, the Tarmorita with Latios if it works. And Alakazam could stop it if it's Sash. So, but I will remove the Sash in this case, so that's fine. The other actually thing that looks great against Dice in this game is Jirachi. As expected and as Jirachi said, Jirachi works really well here. I just need once again to weaken Rotom, but once Rotom is weakened, everything is in trouble against Jirachi. So something to keep in mind as the game goes. Another thing that I would like to point out, and that's about the lead I'm about to pick. When you face people with Among Us in general, some things they commonly do is lead Among Us and get a Spore turn 1. Why? Because Among Us can tank pretty much everything you can throw at its face, and it has a free Spore because it'll stay in, then it can switch out and Regenerator will get its health back. So you get that sleep, And that's something Amogus player like to do in general. And that's why I like sub a lot in black and white. You can abuse that habit for most Amogus player. You put your Pokemon with your sub on turn one, and then you have momentum on your side. And that's what I did. As expected, Dice leads Amogus, and I go Jirachi. And I sub right away. And he does the spores, and I just explain. Like, it's not a bad strategy, but it's something you can take advantage of when you build your team. Put something with subs that doesn't care about Among Us, and you will get that nice turn 1 sub against a lot of players. So I really like this, because not only do I get my sub, but Jirachi is a big threat, so I can start going at it with it. Turn 2, I immediately T-Bolt. Among Us has no business sailing on Jirachi, and Rotom can switch in pretty freely, like it gets good what the Jirachi has, so let me get those damages real quick. I T-ball here, 20%, nothing too great, but that's some damage, and that puts it in a closer and closer to Latios range. So he breaks the sub with Hydro Pump on the next turn. I sub again. The reason why I sub is that because Rotom, I don't think Volswitch breaks the sub, and Woe obviously does nothing. So I try sub here to see what he's gonna do. He pumps right away again, he wanna break that sub, that's normal. Props on him. So here, I go Tyranitar. The reason why is, I kind of want the rocks up. Like, they are not really needed, but I want them. But the main reason why I go Tyranitar right away is that I want to get the sand up. I don't want Rotom 12 leftovers recovery. Because as soon as sand is up, every damage I can get on Rotom it sticks around. And I can actually also weaken the Rotom more and more with Iron Head. Like, if I get a sub against Among Us later or versus Salakazam or Tyranitar, if Rotom switch in, I can Iron Head and rack up damages with the flinches thanks to Sand cancelling the leftovers. So I switch Tyranitar here to get my rocks. He will always be good play on his part, although Hydro Pump would have rocked too. But Hydro Pump doesn't even a 2k. He Hydro Pump. He gets a crit, which puts me in a death range with the burn. But it didn't really matter. He would just have to hit another one of his spell. So I got my rocks. And Tyranitar wasn't really useful in this matchup anyway, so whatever. Like, it could have been useful, but not too much. So I can play with that. I go to my bottom. And I Volswitch, I kind of hoped I would be slower, to be fair. So I could Volswitch and have momentum on my side. I'm faster and I get a crit. I appreciate the crit though. It's pretty useful here. But I'm kind of in a pickle. Because I don't have anything I really want to switch into Rotom. Like, since it was a Rotom Ditto, he could have wanted to put a burn on mine. So I don't really have anything I can switch on Will-O-Wisp if he used it. So I go Magnezone because it's the only thing that can take the burn. And he will switch instead. And that's a really big problem here, because he gets Among Us. I explain why it's a really big problem. I have nothing that can really take the sleep at this point. Jirachi is way too precious. Garchomp could... Sorry, I had to sip some water. Garchomp could take the sleep, but that was not, because if I can remove Skarmory with Magnezone, Garchomp is looking really good against him. Latios, obviously, I don't want it to sleep, because it will also be really great as soon as I remove Skarmory. And Rotom, well, I could switch in Rotom, but at the same time, I would give him so much momentum. I was really pondering between putting Rotom to sleep or Magnezone, but I found Magnezone a bit more expendable. So I get the T-Wave instead. The reason why, also, by staying with Magnezone to take the sleep, I can T-Wave and hope for a full paralysis. Like, it's something I could bank on, but I don't get it. It's pause. Pretty big turn here, honestly. I didn't really know what to do, because I was really, really fearing him going straight Garchomp. And I think it was the play it should have made. Because if he goes straight Garchomp, I can't wake up. Like, I have to at least sleep one turn black and white. If he goes straight Garchomp, he kind of forced my Magnezone out, and then I don't get to wake up with Magnezone later. But the thing is, something else that I mentioned is that a lot of Among Us run double status in black and white. And most people, as soon as they get their Pokemon put to sleep, won't stay in again Among Us. So they switch to something else, and the Among Us player can put something to... can paralyze something with Stun Spore afterwards. So I decide to go for that play. I hope he Stun Spore, and he does. Which means I've spent my turn sleeping, so I can hope for that first one turn wake up. So I can, like, the only thing that will force me out at this point is a Garchomp. So I go for it, and he goes Charmander. Doesn't go Garchomp, like, on it, well, I mean, he probably wanted the Rocks Up, but I went for the turn 1 week, I got it, kind of fortunate of my part. I flash cannon right away because it got nice damages against Among Us if he decided to stay in. And it worked against everything else, besides like Rotom, but I don't think he would go Rotom on Magnezone at this point anyway. So I'm pretty happy at this point because not only did I get Among Us out of the field, but I didn't get something to sleep, thanks to the turn 1 week. So I double switch here to Jirachi. I wanted to preserve the Magnezone, now that it's woken up, it's pretty useful to keep around for Scarberry. And I double switch to Jirachi because he doesn't really fear much from Tyranitar, and I expected him to use Stealth Rock anyway. So if I went Jirachi on Tyranitar using Stealth Rock, I could return him with Iron Head, and it looked good against everything else in the team anyway. But it works even better here, as it doubles to Among Us. And Jirachi against Among Us is even better at this point. So I get the sub up. I don't want him trying his odds with Spore, as I try to predict. So I just play it safe, I get the sub up, and he goes to Skarmory. So I reveal T-Bolt here, and as you can see, it's a 2-KO, and at this point, I'm really liking the matchup because Rotom is even more threatening than ever. In this instance, you can see that the Skarmory could switch on Jirachi and force it out with Whirlwind, but now that it lost half its health from T-Bolt, it can't do that anymore. Also, it's weakened for later, which is always good. So it gets in, it didn't get Magnezone, but it got Rotom, so that's pretty good here. I can Volt Switch for free. I really don't want his Among Us to come in on Rotom, as I will Wisp or Hydro Pump because they will get to put something to sleep. So I just want to Volt Switch and keep the momentum. And when I get Jirachi on the field again, he go Garchomp, pretty good move on this part, as it blocks Volt Switch, but Garchomp isn't safe against Rotom. And like, so what can I fear at this point? The Garchomp could be a lot of things. I don't think it rocks because the Tyranitar didn't take much from Flash Cannon, so it's probably bulky, and bulky Tyranitar run rocks in black and white. So the Garchomp has to be something either offensive, like SD, Special, or Scarf. Scarf makes the most sense in this team, and I think I can keep under control every kind of Garchomp at this point, even if it use sub on Rotom, and as I use Volt Switch again, I can just break the sub the next turn with Hydro Pump, and then keep the Garchomp in check with either Latios or my own Garchomp. So I decided to Volt Switch again because I didn't want Among Us to stay in for free, and he went Among Us, wanted to get the sleep, but I Volt Switched again. And I get Jirachi on the field once more. So to go back on the Garchomp turn, even if, like, nothing Garchomp could have done would have been too threatening for Rotom at this house. It would have to be SD, but SD I can handle because it has to use Ultra H to take down Rotom, and if it has Ultra H, I can kill it the next turn with Garchomp or Latios. So didn't really fear it too much, at least for one turn, and that's why I decided to Volt Switch again, in case he would go to his own Among Us. And that's what happened. So I get Jirachi again, and at this point Jirachi, as you can see, and as I mentioned earlier, like, it will kill something, because Skarmory can't come in anymore to Whirlwind it, since it took the T-Bolt. He got Rotom instead. Rotom doesn't have much health back, so decide to sack it. I get the sub on Among Us, and at this point I'll just, since I'm really safe behind the sub, I'm just gonna Iron Head, try to get the finch, I get it, now it's in T-board range, thanks to the sand that I put up earlier. And Joachi, so something really obnoxious with Joachi in black and white is leftovers, because when you are behind the sub and you spam those iron head, or you force a lot of switch with your coverage, you get at the same time that alts back with leftovers. And just to put it in perspective, when you get the sub, you get 6% from leftovers, and the next turn you get another 6% that's half the alts lost. Sorry for repeating myself, but that's half the damages you had to take yourself from making the sub. So it goes back on pretty quick. You get a lot of HPs back with leftovers. So as you can see, nothing is good against Jirachi here. It works really well. He has to go Alakazam, and which I will appreciate. I appreciate it because I can break the sash if it's sash. I use Icy Wind. The reason why is because I make it slower, and I can then put it to. I can kill it with an Iron Head or just fish for a fringe. Not like it can kill me anyway. I decided to sub though because I kind of expected him to sack the Tarmogoyf here, or maybe go Garchomp on a predicted Iron Head. So I tried to sub because I want to get as much as Jirachi as I can, as much from Jirachi as I can get in this position. But Dice made a good play here. He Shadow Ball instead, and he breaks the sub. It doesn't allow me to get too much leeway from Jirachi. Another good play. Since I was getting low on hearts, I didn't want to sub again. I wanted to keep some HPs. So I Iron Head instead, and this time he goes Garchomp. So now I'm forced out. See, at this point, I was expecting him, like, he couldn't afford, I was expecting him to attack the Jirachi, because he had to use Earthquake or Fire Blast to hit it, and since Jirachi was a threat, I didn't think he would double. But I went Latios instead, because Latios can switch on everything that would damage Jirachi, like Earthquake or Fire Blast, or Fire Fang if he had it, or even Aqua Tail, whatever. Anyway, Latios can switch in all those moves, and in the case he doubles to something like Among Us, which is the thing that really annoys me because it puts something to sleep. Latios is fine versus both Among Us and versus Garchomp using like what I just explained. So I go Latios here, nice middle ground that works in all occasions. And Among Us here doesn't want to stay in the face of Latios. Latios could just fire a psychic move and get to do his thing, or fire Draco that would kill from specs. So he wants to keep Among Us around, which is fine because it can still do work against my other four. And I decide to take this turn to use DD since I'm expecting a switch out. And at this point, not only do I get my DD up, but I also force him to go Skarmorinz instead, which is good for me. So I kind of expected him to sell your Charmander, but he goes Skarmory on the predicted Earthquake. When you think about it, if I used Raged here, I would have been in a really great position, but I didn't want to lock myself yet. So I Earthquaked, he goes Skarmory, and I could have gone directly Magneto, but I was expecting him to double to Among Us or Garchomp. Once again, sorry, I was drinking some water again. Once again, I don't want to lose my grip on the momentum. I want to run hot while I'm steaming, if it makes sense. So I Zen it, but instead, I don't want Among Us to stay in, so I Zen it, but he roosts. And at this point, like, it's pretty obvious that I have two choices. I either go Magneton, or I stay in with Latios, and and the thing is, the only thing Skarmory can do against Latios anyway is either Brave Bird, get some spikes, or Whirlwind. But I don't really need Latios either to win, because since I broke the sash from Alakazam, both Jirachi and Garchomp can be nice win condition. So I decide just to stay in with Latios and keep using Zenith Butt, because at most it will have to, like at worst, sorry, it will have to Whirlwind at some point. And then I can, if he gets Magneton out, it will work out for me, and everything else works well. And he, like, the thing is, when you think about it, he had much more pressure than me because he knows that he can't afford Skarmory to die here. Like, if Skarmory gets trapped, he knows that he will lose to Skarmory if it's Skarmory or just Latios. So he has a lot more pressure than me for staying in. And fearing a switch to Magnezone that would make a lot of sense for me, he goes Among Us and I just keep using Zenith Bird instead. And I catch the Among Us on the switch. At this point, nothing can stop Latios in his track besides Skarmory. So he goes back to Skarmory and then this time I directly go Magnezone because he can't punish me anymore. Like, in the past, if he expected the double to Magnezone and got Among Us, it would have been a nice punish because he got the sleep and he gets momentum on his side. But now, if he gets Garchomp, once again, it's not a problem, it's probably a scarf at this point. Alakazam is kept in check by Jirachi and Garchomp. And Charmander isn't doing much anyway. So I go straight Magnezone, especially because he needs the heart on Skarmory too, he needs to lose. So I go straight Magnezone, and now that I get to trap Skarmory, the game is over. Because Scarf Garchomp just beats everything with Earthquake. Magnezone won't even die to anything at this point either, unless it's Garchomp locking itself on Earthquake. And he sends Garchomp in. The only way Garchomp can... Garchomp has to lock itself on Earthquake to kill the Magnezone, and if he does, I just set up with Latios and win the game. He decides to use Fire Blast instead, fine by me. I get some damage on Garchomp. And now the game is over. The only thing that could have been threatening at this point was Salak Garchomp. Like that could have been a thing that was Flash Cannon. You could think it was risky if it was SD Salak. But SD Salak always runs up to make sure it would activate the Salak. Or Angel. And it wouldn't make sense in this team anyway. Because it needs Magnezone or something that would target Steel type in general to weaken them. So knowing it can be this set, I just weaken it with Flash Cannon, and then I clean the game with my own Garchomp, since Cheetah is weak to Earthquake and Alakazam is its Sash broken. And that concludes the game. So once again, I'll just remind that sub Pokemon really good in Black and White, because people like this core right here, Charmander, Skarmory, Among Us. One of the most common core in Black and White right now. A lot of people love to run it. If you watch Mugen 2, you'll see a lot of them. And there are a lot of Pokemon that can abuse these kind of sitting ducks. Like Sub Jirachi, Sub Garchomp 2 if you run Sub Mix. Mixed Sweeper in general behind the Sub are really fearful. Are really fearsome for those teams. So yeah, something to keep in mind, guys. With that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video and this commentary, and once again, if you have questions or feedback, let me know.